traction forces and no demand during stair distance, differential between illumination. It's good to have our last paper from our state. And why is it the stair distance and agent illumination are important? First, four sun stairs are leading cause of accident in the United States. And force during distance is at least three times more frequently than their accidents. And all the individuals are at a particular risk because of functional decline. And a decline of visual may potentially increase the risk. Background. Cohen found that 92% of injury occur while the workers are descending the stair. So he hypothesized that low coefficient of frequency condition might be a major factor in occupational stair distance accident. However, no one at that time has investigated the RCOF and its required coefficient of frequency necessary. And this book that report that SOF, report the data of SOF of overground. And Templer has suggested that SOF for stair distance may be less than that for overground. Hypothesis. The researcher first want to check the hypothesis of the Cohen gave us that the low coefficient frequency condition may be a major factor in stair accident. He also want to see the relationship between this stair negotiation with lining condition and aging. In addition, another purpose is to quantify the RCOF during stair distance and to compare this value with that found in the literature for overground. Subject was 12 older and young adults, and they are in good physical and visual condition. Here's the stairs. You can see there are two fourth platforms on the second and fourth stair, and at the first and end step, there are two photocells to monitor the speed and some safety harness to prevent the injury. There are two levels of luminance. First is 300 experts, which is the upper limit of a civil tree light. Another is 300 experts. Speed was controlling the 0.61 to 0.69 to prevent influence of extreme speed. In the table, you can see that the main signal of the GIF fault is low 45 hertz, so the filter was set at 45 hertz. And there are seven variables we be care about. First two are SOF at full strike and push off. And SOF will calculate by dividing magnitude of shear force by vertical force. Here are five more variables. The first two are peak of the vertical force. The F3, F4 are peak of the anterior posterior force. And the LR is the initial loading rate of the vertical force calculated from 10 to 90% of F1. A five-factor repeated measure ANOVA was conducted, and these five factors are each separated. It has 24 level, and the age group two level of illuminance, two levels the allocation, and five level of trial order. Because under every condition there are five trials, so the level is five. Here is the result. Trial order had no significant effect, and the As for the luminance, the only significant effect condition was the lower first vertical peak force in the low luminance condition. The luminance level had no significant effect on any of the other dependent GI levels. The stair location had a significant effect on F1, F2, and F3. There is a trend for the F4 towards age and stair location interaction. The elderly had a significantly lower anterior direct shear force on stair 2. And there was a significant stair location and age interaction on LR. Older subject had a significant higher LR on stair 4. RCOF at full strike was lower in the mid-stair region. And the older subject had a lower RCOF FS when compared with the young. And the other results were now reported in the paper. Discussion. The GIF profile had a distinct pattern. You can see the first vertical peak force is higher and the second vertical peak force is lower. Second, the OF is comparable to that of overground, and except the RCOF at push-off, which was 2.1 to 2.2 less during stair distance. And the age effect that have been found can be interpreted as a less vigorous push-off and more cautious use of available friction. Shoe stair interaction, in the shoe stair interaction model, then we highly dependent upon the stair region, and sleep would be more likely to occur on the transition step. That means the step 2. It is surprised that illuminates do not have much effect on this GIF. Maybe they influence the clearance and the placement, which were not measured in this study. And here's the main conclusion we have already. Mentioned that RCOF is comparable to that of overground. GIF have a specific pattern, and the other subject was more cautious, and illuminance did not result in major change. And under normal condition, frictional factor play a minor role in the stair stiffness. And I found this there in our lab. Thanks. That may influence the F1, F2, you know, the vertical force. So that may make the influence of the illuminance and the aging not that significant.
Did they say what surfaces they actually walked on when walking up the stairs that created the different frictions?
No, I think it's just a normal surface. And they also mentioned in the conclusion that on the normal surfaces, maybe the friction factor is not that important.